All right, Bootleg Toys, Vietnam. I'm an American living in Saigon. I do bootleg toy hunts and toy hauls. Let's look at some cool stuff that I found today. It's been a while since we did this. So, due to popular demand, here we are. I have told you before, when I see little things that are in a series, we never can find the full set. So sadly, this was a series of 5 dealies, and there were only 4. So, it seems to be a Sentai thing. Take a look here. Triceratops. First of all, we've got a little Triceratops here. Predator Fighter is the name of the line. And you can take a look and tell me, what is this thing? Is it like a Dino Thunder Megazord? Is this Sentai? It seems to be. I tend to always think that Sentai are Voltron, but that's not true. So here's Triceratops. He was A, or she was A. And then Arctic Wolf, who is very cool. Blue Arctic Wolf from Toy Block. Clearly, this is made in China. The back is the same for all these. So, Predator Fighters. This was my favorite. The Fierce Tiger, which has a Tiger Zord vibe, right? So, the Predator Fighter parade continues with Wild Bear. The Purple Wild Bear. So, pretty cool. It looks to me like there's some kind of golden cat or maybe another wolf that was missing from the line. So, I'll look for the wolf C. There's those things. We're starting small, and we're gonna go big as we move through this. So I did find a box of boot Lego. Again, there were 8 in this line. These are more Spider-Man toys. This is a Spider-Man Noir, who's one of my favorite characters, character designs from the Spider-Verse, from Tiger. Again, China. This is an 8-in-1. So you can see here, there's Venom riding this wild, Wild West spider mech. But you've got Silk, you've got Spider-Man Noir, Spider-Gwen, Cosmic Spider-Man, regular Spider-Man, Carnage, and Spider-Man 2099, another character design that I always loved. Maybe you did too. So you can see that they come with 8 little jet skis and smaller pieces, and you combine them all, and then you've got 8 figures with one giant mech. So, same here. I got my 2 favorites. Several of the figures were missing. There was maybe 5 of 8 that I could find. I always dug this. I think that's Spider-Man 2099. I remember him having some navy blue, but alas, this is bootleg. So, a couple other Marvel Lego sets that I ran into. Another 8-in-1 here. This was Captain Mar-A-L, right? They flipped the V, as it were. But this is a pretty cool setup. So it's all the Kree warriors from the film, of course. You remember Captain Marvel. I feel like this film is already on the wayside. There's Ronin and Thanos, and anyway, it doesn't suck. Captain Marvel from Lezzy. So, this was the Jude Law character, Marvel. He kind of looks like Jude Law. That's why I got it. I picked up the Jude Law. This is Heroes Gathering, which is one of the many bootleg lines, and then Gemma Chan's character, Dr. Minerva, who I think was a great villain in the comics. She's going to be in the Eternals film now, so I don't know if we'll see her again, but that's too bad, because I like this figure. So, I've kind of growing cold towards Lego minifigures. I did the army building with the white ninjas, and it didn't exactly fill the hole in my soul. So, here's a cool, crappy Captain America dealie. Just an awful, awful, awful cap, which I couldn't resist. A translucent sword that shoots little Avengers discs. So, Avengers Infinity War. This I had to get because it was cap, and it's a crappy cap. And it was only 60,000 VND, that's Vietnam Dong. 60,000, that's less than $3. So, superpower, translucent sword, pretty dope. And then the back of the card is just that Avengers Infinity War poster, right? The art from the card with Spider-Man. So, there we go. Crappy cap toy. You still with me? A few more cool things coming up. So, oh my goodness. Well, I'll show you this first. Because I love this line. And you know I love this line. I found another one. So, it looks like the Menasor on the card. But it had some Computron to him. And if you've watched, this is Freitapan. Some sort of German, Chinese, amalgamation. Or rather, Japanese. So, anyway. It has a afterburner here. If you've watched these videos, God love you, if you have. I've talked at length about how Computron, right? The Technobots and Computron were my first combiner when I was a child. And this has got kind of a mishmash. But, like, Lightspeed was the red sports car who was a leg. And here they've got, like, a Formula One car. So these two are kind of mismatched. He does have a sweet giant gun. But Nosecone, who sadly is wearing a Decepticon sigil. Nosecone and Afterburner, immediately I recognized the orange motorbike and the, like the module. Looked like the TMNT module. I forget what those things are called, but anyway. It would dig in the side of a mountain. So, Freitakon, Freitapond, as usual. Freitapond in the back. So another combiner. I'll add it to the list. I'm trying to decide what to do as far as end of year. So by all means, let me know what you want to see, what you'd like me to look for. I'm starting to really just see the same crap everywhere, so I slowed down a bit. Also had a promotion at work, my role changed, and then I did some traveling. If you watch my, or rather if you follow me on Instagram, Bootleg Toys Vietnam, you could see I was in Hoi An and Da Lat recently. So how about this? I finally picked up a Sentai thing. I'd seen this before, and I swore if I saw it again, I'd pick it up. So here we are. I'm guessing this is Beast Morphers? I don't know. You're going to have to tell me. KL Toy Box, tell me what this is, by all means. Who are these guys? I know that it's super cool and it was clean. Fight the Brigade. I'm pretty sure this is Beast Morphers. It's got to be, right? I don't know my Sentai, but they've grown on me. I've warmed to them. Another sweet, giant, translucent sword. And then there's a lion. There's a, like a hawk, falcon with the Zord's head in the tail, Blue Ranger guy, green antelope, looks to be like an armadillo, or a pangolin, maybe in this neck of the woods, and then Red Ranger, Red Sentai guy. So the back of this card is wild, and makes me want to learn about this. Was never a Ranger guy, but kind of warming up to the Beast Wars Transformer stuff. Anyway, those are some Beast Morphers down there. And then you can see all the various. There's a giraffe. There's a white tiger. There's a black lion. There's like a narwhal. Anyway, there it is, man. Pretty cool, right? So I thought I'd finally get one of these to show you all. I do support the Sentai here. Now, last but not least, friends. Pretty dope, right? This is way too long of a video. Thanks for playing. How about this? Had to get him. It's too much. I'm ashamed at how much I bought this for. This is like $8-$9. Deformation Tycoon. Collect them all. This is a giant Iron Man Seeker Transformer. Revenge Hero Alliance. The latest series. Here's Battle Mode. Revenge Hero Alliance. The latest series. Deformation Tycoon. So Iron Man is a bit of a deformation tycoon. It's got like a Jetfire stature to him. I'm pretty sure that's what it was molded on. And I know it's going to really suck and be crappy, which is why I tend to leave some of this stuff in the box. I dig the box art and the wild card stuff sometimes more than the actual robots. When you open it up, it'll be just like a plastic PVC shell oftentimes. So a pretty sweet nonetheless. Maybe I'll open this and see if it doesn't suck too bad. With the price point, it might be better than I think it is just looking at it. But how cool is this? Iron Man Jetfire. So my number one when I do hunt Marvel or DC Transformers, I'll tell you, I don't want to go back and get it, but I did have to make a choice. There were three. There was Captain America, who becomes like a semi-truck, just like Optimus. I've got a couple of those, not at that scale. This was big, same series here, big line. And then there was a Batman who transforms into the Tumbler Batmobile from the Nolanverse. So that's it. By all means, let me know what you'd like to see. I think I'll do, as I said, some end of year videos, maybe best of, worst of, look at some of the things that I got over the past year. My goal for this whole experiment with YouTube and Instagram was basically to just do a year. And so I hit a year at the end of September. But I keep getting messages, and you keep sending me comments, and you keep subscribing and liking things. So I'll keep it going. We'll see how it goes. That's it. Have a wonderful holiday. Hopefully I'll see you before then. That's my plan. But otherwise, here's the winner, chicken dinner. Take it easy. Next time. Peace.